Polly, and I am the soap maker and maker of all the things here at Missouri River Soap, and I'm going to work on some unscented soaps today. Now, I am so far behind. I don't have any unscented soaps made. I don't have anything to use personally. I don't even have anything to sell. I don't have any, and my winter skin is like, hello, bring on the unscented soaps. It's time. So I'm going to try to catch up today. I'm going to make my Crema Cacao, which is one of my original unscented ones, and it is cream and cocoa butter, just loads of cocoa butter. And I'm also going to make banana buttermilk, which is just a huge favorite. And so I'm really excited to tackle these batches today. I'm going to get all my safety gear on and get to work. So the first thing I want to do is I want to blend up my cream, because I don't know if you can see it, there's some more yellow in it. It is an organic cream and it had some butter chunks in it, so really solidified bits. So I'm just gonna see if I can blend it real simple right here. I just wanted to make sure that that was broken up so I don't have to spend a lot of extra time in here in the oil portion. Oh, it's so nice. Isn't that nice? Oh my goodness. Oh, looks like there was still a little bit. Now my cream usage is a little bit lower because cream is so fattening and this batch is totally gonna try to heat up on me. It always does, and I have lost some of these batches before. So I'm gonna tap out the air bubbles. I'm going to go ahead and add in the lye solution now, and it does have some lye lint, and I think I probably should just start putting this in the video description. If you're curious of what the lye lint is, I'll go ahead and say it again this time. And what the lye lint is, it is simply just a little bit of the sodium hydroxide reacting to the carbon dioxide in the air to create sodium carbonate. And it usually can just go right in. It doesn't affect the batch at all. And the reason why I tend to get it a little bit more is because, one, my water is reduced to make way for cream and sodium lactate, and I try to soap it a little bit of a reduced water solution as is. And the other reason is that the temperature up here is cold, and so it is cooling off quickly. And so the temperature affects it as well. I think instead of explaining it every single time I make a video, I think I'm going to start putting it in the video description so you can maybe go there and take a peek. And I'll just maybe start doing like a little pop-up or something so everybody can just know to go there and read all about it. So I'm going to tap out the air bubbles. If I leave the air bubbles in the shaft, that's going to blend up into the soap, and then we're going to have air pockets when we cut and etc. We don't need that. Okay. Turn it back up to high. So I switched over to my stainless steel Cuisinart from my last video, which had the blue Cuisinart. And I was talking about how I was going to have to retire it because it was vibrating. Well, by golly, these are as well. I've been using these smaller stick blenders for over 5 years, so they're definitely due for replacement. So it looks like we're just very, very much at a light trace. Now this one can move along quite quickly once I get to this phase, so we'll see if it really needs a lot more stick blending. All right, so so I think I'm going to just get the stick blender out of there for a minute and stir it around to just kind of feel how things are going. It's very cold outside, and I'm a room temperature soap maker. And so my attic studio, I talked away from the microphone, is at 65. When I came up here today, it was like, after the heaters had been running for a couple of hours, it was still, I don't know, like 56 or something like that, but we're up to 65. It feels like a heat wave up here. So it's not super cold, but like my coconut oil is a melt point of 76, I do believe. So, you know, we're low. So it's just making a light trace. So I am just going to pause for a moment and just let this come to more of a trace naturally. All right, so it's been about 5 minutes. Let's see where it's at. Oh yes, look at that. That is much better. It is perfect for pouring. I do like a thicker pour because it does help prevent ash as well. So just make sure this is all stirred nicely. Look at that. I would say that's past a light, medium-ish. I mean, it seems thick, but it's not leaving a significant trace. So we are going to get this poured. All right, let's do this. Beautiful, beautiful. It's one of my loves. Plus, if I pour it too thin, it's just gonna try to seep around the paper, and who needs that? Ah, so creamy. My goodness gracious, so nice. Just gonna give this a scrape down. It's gonna take me a moment. So just gonna give it a little shimmy and a shake. You can see it's still quite thin, quite. And so I'm probably just gonna leave it right here. It's my most level table, I think, around here. So I'm just gonna give it a little bit of texture, just holding just the smallest amount. But you know what? We're gonna smack this down. I was just seeing some air pockets there. All right. So this is just pretty much the end of Crema Cacao, and I am going to get ready to make the banana and buttermilk. Okay, moving on now to the banana buttermilk, and I'm going to use one whole banana, depending on how it looks really here. And I want to weigh it out so that I know exactly how much I have, because it all is a part of my water portion. All right, 4.25 ounces. I reduced the water in my lye solution by 8 ounces to accommodate my buttermilk and the banana. That does come out of that portion. So now I'm going to add in the buttermilk until I get to 8 ounces. It's another organic milk. All right, so there we are at 8. Aside from it being buttermilk, it does look like the beginning of a really delicious smoothie. I have been obsessed with bananas recently. I switched out to my Mahusive stick blender, but I don't need this big old thing quite yet. But it doesn't really work. This is a shorter part, so it doesn't really work super well with the main batch here. So I'm going to really blend this well. You know what we're going to do to assist this matter? Okay. You are being a bit of a pill, but I will allow it momentarily. We're gonna add in some of the oil to help. We need to have a little bit more in that cup. All right, let's go back to this now. It is gonna make a racket, unfortunately, because, I don't know, the stainless steel. So once I feel like this is blended really well, I'm gonna blend it more because we don't want any big bits at all going into our batch. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and strain it in, and that's gonna catch any big pieces that might be left behind. It's an extra security measure there. So it didn't catch a lot, but it did catch some of those, are those seeds? I guess they're seeds, right? You would think that they were seeds. Anyway, the little brown bits that are in a banana. And then I need to get everything out of this one that I can. Now, you're probably wondering, hey lady, why can you even put banana in a bar of soap? Well, it's because it's cold processed soap and we're working with the lye solution, which in essence preserves the whole thing. That's why we can use milk, etc. Now, it's very important not to overdo it, not have any big pieces and such. Has to be done safely. All right, so now I'm going to really blend it into the oils well. That's looking really good. And I actually might be able to use this shorter stick blender. I'm gonna see how it goes. I'll leave this one close by. And there is just something so special about adding banana to soap. I don't know what it is. It's super creamy. It adds some sugar, which helps the bubbles. It's just delightful. All right, so now in with the lye solution. All right, so I'm just gonna simply bring this to a trace. All right, I guess I did okay. Didn't even come to the top there. So creamy. There's some speckles occasionally that you can see from the banana. Now, in my experience, the finished soap will have specklage. That's just the way it is, and it's a cool look. Definitely looks like banana. Back in the olden days, I made a batch of soap with banana, and I used some, what was it? I think it was like fresh baked bread or something, a fragrance oil from Wholesale Supplies Plus. Whoa, I really need to do that again because it was so good. I think I'm gonna go ahead and wait again just a little bit, let it come to a little bit of a thicker trace before I pour. All right, it's looking good. About time to give this a pour. It smells amazing. You know the smell of banana bread before it goes in the oven? It's a very similar scent at the moment. I love that flour, as in all-purpose flour, the flour scent. Let's see, I think I can do it this way. Anyway, I like that floury scent that you get in the dough before you bake things. Mmm, so good. All right, here goes. Banana buttermilk going in the mold. So luscious. Oh my goodness. So right now, you don't really see any specks much. they're there. I can see them on my side of things. I don't know how much you can see, but it's so light and faint, but they will darken considerably. Nice. All right, let's take some time to scrape this again. I'm just going to texture this one pretty much the same as I did the Crema Cacao. Oh, so good. I really do enjoy making unscented soaps. The batter is just like a thin pudding look. I love that look. There's not very many dishes to clean up. It's just delightful. Okay, so here we have Crema Cacao and banana buttermilk, and I am going to just very lightly cover these just to prevent ash. They're both going to try to heat up a little bit, and I will see you back here for the cut. It's time to start cutting the unscented soaps. So this is the Crema Cacao, and I will cut it first, clean up my cutter and everything, and come back and do the banana buttermilk. I think this is going to be really hard to cut because I kind of forgot about filming the cutting videos for the unscented soap, so oopsies. And so let's give this a try. Hopefully I don't break my wrists off. Oh, yep, it's hard. Okay. It's pretty simple. It's just a creamy soap. I love it. I just love Crema Cacao. It's just one of my absolute favorites. And I can't wait until it is done curing because I'm gonna be all over it. It's one of those that I'm like, why do I not keep this around all the time? Because I need it in my life. It is so good. So good. So I will cut this last little piece here. So much easier just to cut a small part. It's looking really good. I'm not noticing any separation from overheating, but I will see what some of the, I'm not gonna skip that one right now. I think I'll just get out my single cutter to do those. Ah, here's a little bit. Really? I did not have to wallop my pour. So, okay. So, we're looking right here. And I know I got some shadows going on in here. I've got to refigure my lighting setup. I love it for me. It works out perfect. But we do have a little bit of shadows on filming. So, you can see right there, I'm gonna try to hold it steady. That's a little bit of a heat separation. I usually just keep those bars for myself. And I don't find them really to be a problem. Just aesthetically, I keep them for me. So, win-win. Sometimes soap makers don't get to use, hold on. Sometimes soap makers don't get to use full-size bars, and sometimes we'll order bars from other people just to utilize a full bar of soap, but that's just silly. We need to be just taking that time and pleasure with our own products, even if it does cost us just a little bit to take it for ourselves and not sell it. So let's see. So here it is on this edge, but I don't see anything inside. So that's a good sign. It wasn't just like a widespread thing. It's just sometimes like right in the middle, it does that. It's been really cold upstairs. And so when I've come up and I'll have to start my heaters for the day, today I'm 63. because it was warm yesterday, but it's cold outside now. But sometimes I'll come up and it's only like 45 degrees or so. And so that does help the soap not to overheat. I don't seem to have any problems gelling even when it's cold and I soap at room temperature. But it does help it not to get too carried away. So I'm gonna finish cutting these and then I will come back for the banana buttermilk. All right, so here we are to cut the banana buttermilk. And you can really see those speckles now, can't you? It's so cool. I love that look, actually. And, you know, we strained it out, the banana. We put it through the strainer and everything. And this is still what happens. This is what it looks like as it goes through the saponification process. I just really, really like this banana buttermilk soap. I feel like the banana and the buttermilk is such a great combo. And I think I originally came up with the idea when I was making some banana bread one time and I used buttermilk. And I just love the smell of like buttermilk and vanilla and buttermilk and banana. Now these don't actually smell like anything other than just like milky soap, cocoa butter. It's just soap. It's unscented soap. So it has been just over a week since I made this soap. And I cut it about a week ago. And so it's been sitting here waiting for me to film. So you can see how the inside has changed. That as it's exposed to the air, or as the air, you know, has basically, it's kind of like vanilla discoloration, vanillin is how it ends up working. But it will all turn this brown color. And they just look so good. It's just so funny. And basically why the spots are so big is that it has just bled out, as botanicals, natural things do tend to do. Like if you use tea or coffee, even though it's just like super, super tiny and everything, it tends to just like bleed and make a bigger halo. I don't know why I sit there and line them up perfectly, because it doesn't actually matter. I'm just gonna put it on a tray. So yeah, it's so fun. And they're a little bit darker here on the inside. And I don't know how I managed to get a little bit of glitter apparently was blowing around the other day. So I will have to be extra cautious to make sure all that glitter becomes detached from all the bars. Just a little bit on the outside. Some of the outside bars I've noticed. All right. It's simple. There's not much to it, but I just love it. I just love it. So I cut my sample here. I love having all these samples. That's kind of like, you know, when in your home life, how a full pantry feels good, like you know you're good to go, you can make lots of meals, etc., without having to go to the store, do any extra work, etc. That's how samples feel like to me. I just love knowing that I have a bunch of samples that I can choose from that I'll be able to send out in the orders. I just love it. It's almost just a comfort thing. It does kind of drive me nuts that this plops over, but I really don't feel like having a big, like, something here. I usually use, like, one of my silicone molds for my wax melt making. So you can see this was an outside, pretty close to the outside here. We just had the one little in piece. And then inside, it's still rather light colored. So fun. It is just so fun. I was looking back at my product picture for this soap, and I don't think I have to change anything. So that's really convenient. I mean, it pretty much does look the same every single time. So I'm just going to continue cutting. Here we have the banana buttermilk unscented soap. It really doesn't smell like bananas or buttermilk. It just smells like a creamy milk soap. And thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.